Hi everybody, it's Mary Beth Ions with her romantic violin. I'm going to serenade you with some of my favorite love songs. We have Valentine's Day today, and I think that music is a great way, along with chocolates, of course, candy, to celebrate this day. And I feel that the violin is just indeed very romantic and very much able to, as a voice, convey love and caring and warmth. So that's what I want to achieve today with this program. I'm going to start with a song called My Funny Valentine. It's a perfect one for this day. We'll start off with the trademark song for Valentine's Day. I love to see violins on television, which you often do these days. You see violins accompanying rock stars. As a matter of fact, about a year and a half ago, I played backup for The Who. Roger Daltrey and The Who used a whole string section. Rod Stewart uses strings. And even if you watch Super Bowl at halftime, there were gentlemen playing the violins, but not really. They were just air violin. They were faking it. But somebody recorded real violin, and that sounded good. So violins are everywhere. They're in restaurants, where I will be also on tonight. I will be at a restaurant in Cleveland Heights called Taste. I'll be serenading the diners, as I did last night. And it's always fun to kind of get up close and serenade. And this is the next best thing. Okay, I'd like to start now with a quicker song called Kiss Me Once and Kiss Me Twice. Kiss Me Once Again. Pretty soon we'll be able to do that. Right now we have to air kiss, right? So here we go. And Kiss Me Twice. My mom loved that song. She used to sing that to me all the time. George Gershwin, who wrote Porgy and Bess, he wrote many, many love songs for different movies, different shows, and some of his most famous ones have the catchiest lyrics. They're so clever. Our love is here to stay. In time, the Rockies may crumble. Gibraltar will stumble. They're only made of clay. but our love is here to stay. It's very clear. Of this song are come to papa do. So I changed it to come to mama do. And I'll show you where that happens in this song. There's a song that actually started my love of the violin. It's a song by Nat King Cole that I listened to as a child when my mother would put it on the stereo. And I was so in love with this song and the strings that were in the background of this song. Strings that were supporting this song and giving this song even more sweetness. And I thought, I have to someday sing that song or something. Well, the something turned out to be violin, which is much better than my singing, believe me. And I even got to play backup for Natalie Cole. Many years ago, she was at Blossom Music Center. And unfortunately, there was a terrible rainstorm, and the rain was pounding on Blossom's pavilion, and it wiped out some of the sound, which is a shame. But everybody got invited to come into the pavilion and out from the muddy slides out in the hill area of Blossom. But she did the duet with her father being superimposed on the backdrop, and they sang together. And here is the beautiful song, Unforgettable. So beautifully by Nat King Cole. Another one I love that Johnny Mathis made very popular is the song Misty. And for many years at the Front Row Theater, I'm sure many of you are too young to remember the Front Row, but it was a theater in the round and it revolved, the stage revolved. So there really wasn't a bad seat in the house. You got to see the performer every, I don't know how often it rotated, but you got to see a lot of the performer no matter where you sat. And I did play for Tony Bennett, backup for Tony Bennett, for Johnny Mathis, Perry Como, all these stars would come in. Gladys Knight and the Pips, just so many stars. And we would, they'd need a violin section, a string section in the pit, and I would be there playing. And to this day, Johnny Mathis still comes back to Cleveland, and I often play in the orchestra for him at the Palace Theater. So here's a little taste of Johnny Mathis' Misty. One line in that song says, "Walk my way, and 1,000 violins begin to play." And I often think how terrifying that would be, 1,000 violins coming at you. Now, that would actually be quite nice. I'm so happy to be mask-free today. Here's the mask I usually wear, well, especially on Valentine's. If I were with you in person, I'd be wearing this sparkly pink mask. But no need. And someday, I would like to have a mask burning. Just get rid of all of them. And hopefully that won't be in the too distant future. I'd like to move on to, guess what? More love songs. I think that movies have such a wealth of beautiful music, especially love songs. And they stay with us for decades. I remember seeing Love Story back in 71. And theme to this day still sounds fresh. It still sounds good, and it's a beautiful, beautiful song. It was written by Francis Lai, L-A-I, and it's really stood the test of time. I think I'll play a little bit of Love Story for you.
Thank you.
from Love Story. Love is never having to say you're sorry. Wasn't that the logo? Some of you youngsters aren't going to know what I'm talking about, but that's all right. Because, I'll tell you why that's all right. I'm going to play a few things that I think you'll know and love. If any of you saw the movie A Star Is Born with Lady Gaga and the most handsome Bradley Cooper, you will remember that in one scene toward the beginning, I believe, Lady Gaga is in a bar and she's singing La Vie en Rose. It's a French song. It means the life in red, red color of life, like a happy, very happy, delightful life. And Lady Gaga is kind of lying down on a bar or something singing this song, and Bradley Cooper is just enamored with her. So here's a little bit of that song. In fact, I'll play the whole thing from the movie A Star Is Born with Lady Gaga. There we go. The V and Rose, beautiful song. It sure captured the heart of Bradley Cooper. Other themes from the movies are wonderful. Disney, many love themes. Beauty and the Beast, Aladdin, and there's even the theme when the dogs are eating a single piece of spaghetti. I tried to find that and I didn't have luck finding it, but I do have a little bit of Beauty and the Beast and a little bit of Aladdin. So here we go with Beauty and the Beast.
Thank you.
songs from Disney, Aladdin and Beauty and the Beast. They're lovely, and often when I play for kids, I'll do some of that, a little bit of Frozen, a little bit of Pocahontas, which is a beautiful song also. And moving on with other themes that we all may know and love, Titanic is always a favorite. It's funny, sometimes I'll play somewhere and people will say, just me playing reminds them of the Titanic. I don't know if that's good or bad, but I don't know. Well, the Titanic, everybody went like this, including the musicians who were apparently the last to go. They kept playing. And the people on the lifeboat have attested to this and said it's true. But the movie Titanic from about over 20 years ago had a gorgeous song in it. Celine Dion made it famous, and it's the theme to the Titanic. You can think about Leo DiCaprio as I play this. There we have the theme to the Titanic, always a beautiful song. I love the movie Casablanca, had a wonderful famous song in there called As Time Goes By. You must remember this, a kiss is still a kiss. Beautiful song.
Thank you.
go as time goes by. One of my favorites. I love it. Another favorite is, in fact, it was on television not too long ago, The Godfather, parts 1, 2, and 3. And the theme song in the beginning, when they first roll the credits, or when they start, they roll something in the beginning, the production company, whatever, whatever, they play this mournful song. Actually played on a trumpet. It even gives it a little more that melancholy sound. But here's the main love theme. It goes like this. Just for fun. So that's The Godfather, and I love the theme. I hear it sometimes, you know, when you hear music in elevators or department stores. I hear it, and I still think, wow, that is really beautiful, and I enjoy listening to it. Another favorite is a really pretty little waltz called Fascination. This is an old song, but it's absolutely charming. And when I play in retirement facilities or nursing homes, it's very popular with the 90 plus crowd. They remember this song well, and I always love to play it for them. My mom loved it too. It's a little waltz. And then after that, I'm going to go into the theme from Doctor Zhivago, otherwise known as Laura's theme. So we start with Fascination.
Thank you.
Oh, there we have Somewhere My Love, Doctor Zhivago. Before that was Fascination. There's Broadway shows that have love songs galore, and many of them are just so beautiful. I love The Lion King because it features the music of one of my favorites, Elton John. And if you remember Can You Feel the Love Tonight, that was a really beautiful song, and I often get that as a request at weddings. So here's a little bit of Lion King, Can You Feel the Love Tonight? A little bit of Lion King, Can You Feel the Love Tonight? There's also a Broadway show that you might have heard of called Cats, and it made a comeback not too long ago, but it never made quite the splash like it did back in the early 80s on Broadway. But the song Memory from Cats really lives on. It's still a beautiful song. And here we go with Memory from the Broadway hit Cats. Thank you. we have Memory from Cats. There's another song called Memories that Barbra Streisand sang about 20 years before Cats came out. Or no, maybe only about 15 or even 10. Because I think it was the 70s and Cats came out in the 80s. So there wasn't that much time between these songs. But Barbra Streisand's Memories was from the movie The Way We Were, starring Robert Redford, who was dreamy, and Barbara singing beautifully. Let's see if I can remember a little bit of that. It's Memories Like the Corners of My Mind, misty watercolored memories of the way we were. Pretty that is. That's a really pretty song. And it's one long phrase. She does the same thing, Barbra Streisand, with Evergreen. They're songs that start and they're just one long phrase, like one long breath. She takes breaths, but you can hardly hear it. They're imperceptible because she makes the phrase just so long and beautiful. So there's two memory songs. Have you ever heard of the Broadway musical Phantom of the Opera? I played it about 180 times. Never got tired of it though. It's so well written. And two of my favorite songs are All I Ask and The Music of the Night. So I'm going to play a little of both. And I'm sure this will bring back some memories. Maybe some of you went to Toronto to see The Phantom, or some of you might have seen it here or somewhere else. It's still playing in New York at a theater. Of course, not now with COVID, nothing's happening. Although I hear rumblings that things are going to start up in some capacity. I don't know how, but very small scale. But this is a little bit of the Phantom of the Opera, Music of the Night.
Thank you.
ask of you in Music of the Night from Phantom of the Opera. It's so good to play this concert for you. There's really been very, very little playing over these months, and I'm usually a very full-time active musician, and this pandemic has just silenced us, and it's very frustrating. And so an opportunity like this is just so, so treasured, and I thank you guys. I want to thank especially Kathy Jones and Leslie Paulette and the tech wizard herself, Kelsey. Thank you, Kelsey, for helping me do this. I grew up counting on my fingers and doing things the old-fashioned way, so this was a real help to have you hook me up with this method of doing this by Facebook, which is so much better than Zoom, because Zoom instruments do not sound rich and lovely on Zoom. It's made for the speaking voice. So Zoom is not my method of choice, but this way certainly is. So I thank you, Kelsey, for that. I don't know if any of you watch Netflix. There are so many good things to watch to kill time. And one of them is called Outlander. And my husband and I started watching Outlander, and we just went through four seasons. And it was very, very good. I encourage you to watch it, not with kids around, just with the adults. But it's very good. And it has a Scottish tune that's played in the beginning. It's called the Skye Boat Song. Skye is an island off of Scotland. If you've ever heard of a Skye Terrier, the little dogs, that's their origin. And the Skye Boat Song goes something like this. It's a little waltz, and it's a beautiful Scottish air. It's a beautiful Scottish air. The only one I think I knew before this was My Bonnie Lies Over the Ocean. And now I've introduced another. Oh, I do know another Scottish air. It's called Both Sides the Tweed. The Tweed being a river in Scotland where our fabric tweed comes from. Let me play a little of that for you. It's beautiful. Thank you. really captures like the Scottish feeling. I can just see the Highlands when I play that. So I love to do that. I wish I could be communicating with you guys now. I could take some requests, but unfortunately this is pre-recorded, so I can't. But if I ever do this again, somehow, some way, we've got to get a list of requests to me, because I love honoring requests if I know them. Sometimes you can stump the band here. I have a few more songs. I love Till There Was You from The Music Man. The other popular song from The Music Man was 76 Trombones, but I think this one is so lovely and very big contrast to that booming 76 Trombones. This is a beautiful love song that Shirley Jones sang in the musical, which was written by Meredith Wilson. Till There Was You, another one of my favorites. Some songs are very simple, yet they speak of love in a very simplistic, beautiful way. This one, I'm sure you'll know in the first couple notes. Sweetheart. What a perfect one for Valentine's Day. Also, You Are My Sunshine. Because everything was at a stopping point. But before that, I was playing a lot of 50th anniversary parties. People would call and say, can you come to the house? Or can you come to this banquet center? Can you come to this place? And wherever. And I would go and serenade the couple as they celebrated their 50th wedding anniversary, which makes me think there's something in the demographic now. Probably those folks are in their 70s. They're partying. They have a party, big party with their kids and family. And they're celebrating their golden anniversary. And this doesn't seem to be much of a call for the 25th anniversary. I don't ever hear from people about that. But the golden anniversary, yes. And I'm waiting to have a, is it platinum or diamond anniversary, 75 years? That's if you get married really young. But I love to play for these anniversary parties. There's a song called The Anniversary Waltz, which is beautiful. We danced on the night we were wed. Beautiful song. And another popular one is Wise Men Say Only Fools Rush In, But I Can't Help Falling in Love with You. That was made famous by Elvis, and it's a beautiful song, I Can't Help Falling in Love with You. Falling in love with you. Well, this was a wonderful time for me to bring these romantic songs to you. I hope the next time we meet, it might be in person. That would be wonderful. I'm going to do one more quick song because it's my wish for us all. We've been trying, but the song is called Put on a Happy Face. It's from Bye Bye Birdie, and here we go. Happier face and hopefully being together. Thank you, everybody. Really had a ball playing for you, and I hope to see you again. Lots of love. Bye.